If you've ever needed to send files from your iPhone or your iPad to your Mac or PC, then I'm going to show you a super simple way, purely using iTunes and your charging cable. Stick around. G'day, this is Doug from Doug Hewson YouTube, and we're here to help you with tech for content creation. And many, many people out there are using iOS devices, your iPhones, your iPads, to create content. And whether you're using third-party apps or stock camera apps or whatever it might be, whether it's video, audio, animations, different things that you can create with all the plethora of apps that are available on iOS. Well, today I'm going to show you how to use iTunes on your Mac or your PC to get those files from those apps onto your computer so you can do with them what you will. We're going to head right on over, but before we do, I'm going to explain something that a lot of people don't go into, a lot of people don't understand about the way Apple has their iOS devices set up. And it's a thing that Apple calls sandboxing. Every app has its own document space. Basically, there's not a common file folder system like on a PC or a Mac. An app has its own dedicated storage. So any document, any file that you create using, say, iMovie, a camera app, an audio recording app, an animation titling app, whatever it might be, is usually stored somewhere within that sandboxed document space for that app. And what iTunes will do is allow you to access that easily. So let's head on over to the computer and I'll show you how. I've just jumped over to my desktop and I've opened up iTunes and have plugged in my iPhone 8 Plus, as you can see here. It's very simple. If I've recorded something in a certain app or have data in a certain app, a file of some sort that I wish to work with or move to my PC or my Mac, you can see once the phone's plugged in, I've gone to the phone layout here. There's an option down here called file sharing. We open this up and you can see that there's a bunch of apps that are on my phone. So these are apps that could possibly, may or may not have data in it. In this case, I'm using Filmic Pro because I've just recorded some things on my camera. So I'm gonna go to Filmic Pro and you'll see that you can see there's a bunch of movie files there. Now the ones I want is the last four that I've recorded today. So I'm gonna grab those. I'm just gonna scroll down the bottom and I'm gonna click save. And what I'll do is I'll get a dialogue asking me where I want to save it to. Movies file is perfect. And navigate to the folder where you would wish to save them and then click save. As you can see in the top here of iTunes, right here, it says copy files, and it's copying one of four files. So that's the progress bar for all four files right there. So now we're just going to wait till that process is up, and then it's done basically, because once the files are there, once that progress bar has finished, the files will be in the location that you've moved them to. So it's as simple as that to move a file from your iPhone to your computer. Now say you want to go the other way, it's just, say I've got a general document. Oh, let's go find a document. So I want to get, instead of going save, because it's blanked out, I'm going add. So this is me moving a file from here to the Documents app on my iPhone. So I'm going to go to the Documents folder, somehow has ended up in the iCloud. So I've got a file, I just want to send that to the app. So I've selected that. I might want to select several apps, but I'm just going to send that one file. That is part of the copying process. It's still copying those video files that I'm sending. So it's added now. You can see up the top here, it says copying two of five. So it's added, had those four videos that it was working on. I've added an extra file that's going the other direction. So it's in the list to get done. They're getting copied across right this minute, so we'll just wait for that to finish up. I've just jumped over to the movies folder to show you the files that we've copied across, which are these ones here. There's the four files there. All right, you can see now that I've got that iPhone desktop, and the app that we transferred that file to is this one called Documents by Readle. So let's just have a look and see what folder it should be in. iTunes files, it is channel art tags, but there's that file that we transferred, so we pushed it out there without any problems. That's connected by USB to my computer and transferred via the file sharing feature of iTunes. So if you're into content like that, particularly iOS and Apple space, or anything to do with tech for content creation really, then make sure to subscribe and check the bell so you get notified every time I post a new video or go live. Well, that's all I got for you today. Make sure you check out some of the other great videos we've got that are coming up on the end cards, and I'll catch you later.